In this program, I'm going to show you using recursion how you can print numbers in reverse. It's really simple. So in main, I'm calling the function reverse with the value 5. So it should print natural numbers 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. So what is happening here? If I have to print numbers in reverse, it's quite simple because I'm already passing the number 5. So I'm going to call this reverse. Since 5 is not equal to 0, I'm going to come to the else part. I'm going to print 5 and then I'm going to call this reverse with 1 less than 5, which is 4. So next time it becomes 4. Is 4 equal to 0? Is false. So it's going to print 4. Next time I'm going to call reverse with 3. It's going to come here. 3 equal to 0? Again is false. It'll print 3. Reverse becomes 2. It'll go back. So this way it will continue and start printing from 5 all the way till 1. So in order to understand this, we are going to take the help of the activation record or the stack frame to understand how the calls are happening and how the values are getting processed. Either use the trace, recursion trace, which I showed you in the factorial and sum of numbers, or use the stack frame, whichever you are comfortable to solve a recursion problem. So let us say I'm calling main. Main is called or invoked by the operating system and main is calling reverse of 5. So this is how on the stack frame main will get loaded and it's made a call to reverse 5. Then what happens is n, the value of n now is 5. Okay, so 5 equal to 0 is false. So I'm going to come here, and here if you see, the printf is first, the printf is before the reverse, so it's automatically going to print 5. So you're going to get 5 on the screen. Then I'm calling reverse. Since I'm calling in recursion, this frame cannot be popped because this has not yet completed execution. It is still executing. So now I'm calling reverse with 4. So next time when reverse of 4 is called, okay, then again I come in here. N is 4. You can see N is 4. 4 equal to 0 is false. I am coming here. Print 4. So after 5, 4 is going to be printed. Then I am calling reverse with 4 minus 1. I am calling reverse of 3. So this function reverse of 4 has not yet completed execution because I have called reverse of 3 and I am waiting for its result. When I call reverse of 3, okay, I am passing the value of n as 3. N is 3. Now since n is 3, 3 equal to 0 is false. I am coming to the else part. I am printing 3. 3 is being printed. Then n is 3 minus 1 is 2. So I am calling reverse with the value of 2. So after reverse of 3, I am calling with reverse of 2. Once I go to reverse of 2, n is 2 because the value of n which was passed from here was 2. 2 equal to 0 is false. So I am printing the value of 2 on the screen. After I print, I am calling reverse with the value 1. So my next call on the left side, you will see reverse 1. The value of n is also going to be 1. 0 equal to 1 or 1 equal to 0, false. I am going to print 1. Now I am calling reverse with 1 minus 1 is 0. So now you see what happens. When n is 0, 0 is equal to 0. So this return completes. So I am going to take this out, or I am going to pop out this particular function because there is a return 0. Now since 0 was returned, my execution has come back here. Since I have already calculated, this has been calculated, this function was executed. It is popped out of the stack. That means this processing is also over and reverse of 1 execution is complete. So I pop this fellow out of the stack. Now since reverse of 1 has been processed, printf was already processed before, reverse of 1 got processed. Since that stack frame got popped out, that means reverse of 2 also has completed execution. I pop this fellow out. Then what I do is reverse of 2 was popped out. It was already executed. So this line got executed, means this reverse of 3 has also completed execution. So I pop this fellow out. Then I come here. Reverse of 3 had already been popped out. Okay. So reverse of 4 also has completed execution because this got executed. So I pop this fellow out. Sorry. So I pop this fellow out. Now what happens is reverse of 4 was popped out, indicating this was already executed. So I pop this fellow out. Finally, after I return back, I come here. This also will get popped out and the control will go back to the operating system. So I hope this has further enhanced your understanding of how recursion works. Please try to run through this program multiple times, through these videos multiple times, then your clarity is guaranteed.